that IP which I've shared with you, which I'll share with you again, don't worry. So the presentations are already shared in that online sheet. You can click the link. Okay. I'll also share in the. There are also some case studies which we'll go through between 7:30 to 8 on some days. Okay. Yeah. Have you been able to do those machine learning exercises? Wonderful exercises. I've done with mushrooms. Breast cancer data sets and leukemia as well. They're wonderful, actually. I got a good accuracy with both S0, T1 and vice versa. Yeah.
I can actually share and then show WinSCP and PuTTY for them. Kind of course, it is also on from the browser.
Yeah.
Not from the. Yeah. Yeah. Meanwhile, you can try to recover your cookie. Yeah.
I'm inside, right? No, I'm not joined yet.
You are.
Yes.
Yes, you are with two times. Yeah, you're there. So
yeah, I'm sharing the screen now. I think you can. Yeah. So, yeah. So, what we will do here is this is a terminal in my Linux, as you could see in the whole screen, as you could see. So in case of WinSCP, you need to, when you click WinSCP, you'll get two boxes, okay? The host name, okay? So for that, in the host name, simply type what you call this thing, okay? Only this IP address. This is our server, okay? So this is our, should I increase the font?
Yes, it will be good, Prashant, increase the font. No, you should click on the custom font and then change, not the internal terminal size. Cancel that. Yeah. And then click on the size of the down size.
Yeah.
48 will be too high. Yeah, probably 25 should be fine. 20, 25.
Okay, So, so you will just need to type this thing in. If you are using WinSCP, only the IP number, which is internet protocol number or the host number or the server number. Okay, so this is our server. Okay, this is an external IP. So, and then in the login, you need to, it will ask something like this if you are using a Linux. Okay. There also it will ask you, but for that, you know, you need to give you need to give test username. Sorry, I'm logging in my this thing test. Okay, test is your username. Okay, and then it will ask you the password. Password is very, very this thing, but I'm just, you know, trying to tell you here. Okay, please memorize it. All of you pay attention to this screen, please. Huh? Maybe here I can increase the font and show it to you. So the password is, I'm just keeping it for only 1 second, 1 second, please. Okay, one minute, not more than 1 minute. So this is your, this is the password for that. So please memorize quickly. And the first letter is capitals, okay? And add this and this symbol, okay? Please. So once you do this, I'm logging in. Sorry, 1 minute. Sorry, 1 minute. Yeah. Sorry. You will log in since you're outside. I'm really sorry. You have to give that. Yeah. And give that particular password. Okay. I'm using my own local IP. I'm really sorry for this. So once you give this, you need to give your password. So all of you could log in with this. Okay. Can someone try, say yes if you have logged in? Otherwise, you know, I'll try explaining it to you again.
It works in the Linux.
Yeah, it works in the Linux. Yeah. How about Windows users? Anyone? If you have memorized this password, I'm just closing it, please. Okay. Yeah. Sorry. So could you log in, all of you? Yeah, Dr. Anshu and others. Yeah, could you log in? Not working on Mac terminal. It should work, Abu. I think it should work. Yes, login should be test in PuTTY, and password is the password that I gave you. Okay, it should work in Mac terminal.
Is the login different for Mac?
No. It's the same. The computer is the same.
All right.
You might have given the wrong password. I'm sorry.
For Windows, what will, in case of WinSCP, what will be the host name and username?
Yeah, that's what host name is, that particular, you know, as I told you, the this one, the name, you know, the one, the IP name. Okay. I just told you the IP name, right? Should I type the IP name here?
Yes, it will be helpful.
Yeah, I'll type.
Username also.
Username is test, okay? And the IP or the host name or the computer name is this. This is the computer name or the host name or the server name, whatever.
So okay. I can't.
So login as test, T-E-S-T test. And password, as I told you, I gave you the password, right? Did you all memorize? You should be able to log in. Yeah. It will ask you for some security. This thing, say yes, and then you'll be there. And then click the terminal if you're using WinSCP.
Yes, sir. I have logged in.
Good. How about others? Yeah. Yeah, WinSCP is not here. Otherwise, I would have shown you. I can do it, you know, later. Anyways, that is not important. You please log in. Okay. Could you log in? Yeah.
As of now, only 4 people logged in.
Others? Yes. Okay. Anyways, huh? Even if you are not logged in, we'll do the exercises. Okay. So please do this. So in Linux, you know, it's all case sensitive. So you need to understand that all commands that you write, all the file names that you write, they're all, you know, case sensitive, which means if there is a letter in uppercase, you should give it in uppercase. If it is in small letter, you should give in smaller case. Okay. So PWD is print working directory. So in which directory you are, it says it's in home test. Okay. LS is list. Okay. So list is nothing but a simplest command, but if you give LS minus L, it will tell you the list of what you call files or folders present in your computer like this. Okay. And now the most important step that you really need to do is you need to go into your working directory. So in order to change your working directory, the command is cd. Cd is change directory, workshop. Okay. You can type workshop fully, or when you type W and press tab on your keypad, then automatically it will come because it is only one file called workshop or file folder called workshop. Okay. And then type ls minus l list lengthwise. Okay. So this is where, you know, we have set for you different organismal sequences, okay? Like bacteria, fungi, human, nematode, and virus, okay? So I really want you to enter into any of your folders of your choice, excepting nematode. The nematode file, I'm working on something else, okay? So bacteria, if you're a bacteriologist, get into bacteria. If you're a fungi, get into fungi. Human, go to human. Virus, okay? Viral biologist, you can get into virus. So I'm going to human like this, cd human, change directory to humans. Okay. So I can type clear. Clear is, it will clear the screen. Okay. And it will go to the top. Okay. Is it clear? So I'll type ls minus l. So list lengthwise. So here it tells me that there are two files, test1.fq and test2.fq. It's a fastq file, which is a quality file. Okay, so when I give ls minus lrts, th is tab deleted, h is the human readable format. Okay, it will tell you the size of these particular files. Okay, in in the human readable format, which is, it says 98 MB or 195 MB. Okay. So what is test one? Test one is read one. As I told you, it's a parent file. Okay. It is read from one direction, and test two is the reverse end. Please don't worry about the size. In principle, the forward read and the reverse read should be in the same size. But you know what it was, I was copying the other files when it came up like this. So please don't worry about that. Okay. So if you see the head, test1.fq, head is nothing but the first few lines of your fastq file. Okay. So your fastq file looks like this. It usually has four letters. Actually reduce it, it has become slightly bigger. Okay. Yeah. So it has usually got four lines. So the first line starts with at the rate of, okay. And it will give you the accession number like this and the chrome chromosome and the proposition like this, okay, and then exact sequence. So if you see the number of letters like this, okay, you can count it and go to a Word document. Since you are all new to this, it will tell you that these are 151 bases. Okay, in fact the first one is a space, I think, so it's 150 bases. So it's a 150 base pair sequence read chemistry. Okay, so which means there are 150 base pair short read sequences. Okay, and then there is a symbol called plus separated by this sequence, and then you get the ASCII code for this, the American Standard Code for Information Interchange, for each of these particular every format like this. So this is the entire first sequence or first read, and this is the second sequence or second read, likewise so on and so forth. Okay, so you can count the number of reads, it will be pretty huge. So 98 MB is 98,000 bases. So those many bases are usually present in that. Okay, that is how you can count or something. Okay, something if you're a good user. Okay, I can use something like this, test1q, cat is concatenate or view those particular files and come up with a word count with a list. Okay, so which means it tells you that there are so many number of lines, L is for lines, for that particular file. Okay, you can see that. Likewise for test, if you want, you can go and see that. So there are more lines because the size is more. So basically, you know, it's something, you know, of that particular order of that particular sort. Okay, so just it's only for your understanding. So can you please tell me what would be the very first thing that you would be doing once you get the raw reads? So you have given these raw reads to your service provider. Okay, you got these two raw reads, the paid and reads, test1.fq and test2.fq. So what would you be doing with your files? The very first thing?
Search for any overlapping sequence between the two.
Of course, yeah. And what is that called? What is that overlapping or what is that check called?
Alignment.
Sorry, it is called quality check. Okay. So once you do any experiments in the lab, so how do you check the DNA integrity? You can check the nanodrop readings, absorbance, right? Likewise, you also need to see whether or not the sequencing is done properly or not. Okay. For that, there are different tools. One is FastQC, which is a fast quality check. Okay. There is also called MultiQC or MapQC. There are two or three different programs which allows you to read whether or not the quality of your sequencing is done properly or not. Okay. So for that, the simplest command that you need to do is FastQC. Okay. And this program is already installed in our server. So you need not really worry. Okay. Usually FastQC runs with the premise that it should have a graphical user interface, since ours is a Linux CUI based, the command line user interface. We don't have a server, but it will run the program and then I can copy it and show it to you on a graphical user interface. So don't worry, okay? Even if you run it, I can show it copying into my local machine and show the quality, okay? See, all in small letters, and give your file name test1.fq. So in Linux, when you give ampersand, then you can go to the next command prompt and then you can run the job. Okay, which means that job will run in the background. Okay, so you can run the next background. So when you give fastqc test1.fq ampersand, then it says that there's a job ID that is created like this. Okay. And then you see quickly, it will tell you started analysis of test1.fq, approximately 5% complete, 10% complete, like this, you know, it will tell you. Okay. You need to run this if you are doing it. So what you could do is, since you are so many users, you can create a small directory. Okay. or if multiple users are using human data sets, you can use it. Okay, that doesn't matter. Okay, this is only for your testing this thing. You see, it is quickly running because the file size is small. I only kept, a small file. Okay. So it is like this. So its analysis complete for test1.fk. So it is done. So if zip file called test1_fastqc.zip is created. So likewise, run it for test2 as well. Okay. And then, it says that fast, and then you can come to the command prompt at any point of time. It will run in the backend, okay? And then your test1.fq and test2.fq is done. An HTML file is created. This is very, very important, okay? This file I can copy to my remote, my local machine, okay? If you're using WinSCP, you'll be finding in your own local folder, wherever that WinSCP is there. Okay, so please don't worry. Okay, so please don't worry where that particular and then you can drag it into your desktop. Okay, you will have two windows, your local machine and your other machine where you can drag and drop. Maybe Kiran will demonstrate if he's using Windows over there. Okay. Is this clear?
Unfortunately, I don't have the best
idea. Yeah, it's okay. Otherwise, I'll do it, but let them run it and then I'll copy it. I'll demonstrate, I'll install in a simulator. So friends, could you log in here? Yes, most of you have logged in. It worked, almost several people. Abu Rafi, did you get a Pranshu?
Yeah.
My Spanish friend Ignacio. And Ashok's students. Yeah. From Colombo. Yes, very good. Nishche and group, yeah. And from Bangladesh, KK and group. Yes, good. I think many of you are working on it, so good. So this is how your things are there, okay? So it is saying that it's 95% complete now, and then it will give you the result, okay? So please don't worry if there is some error that comes, it says done, okay? So the file will come, don't worry. It will take some time. Okay? So in the meantime, I'll just copy this file and show it to you how the quality check is there. So what I'm doing is I'm just copying the path like this. So please don't worry, I don't want you to faint. I'm just, remote copying it to my local machine. Okay. So I've copied this particular file and it's somewhere in home. Okay, this test1.fastqc. So can you see the screen, please? Yeah.
Yes, okay. We can see.
Yes. So this basic statistics, it will tell you that this is your test1.fq and it's a Illumina read and the total number of sequences is this. Sequence length, it is saying 16 to 150, but it is usually 150 bases as we have demonstrated. And the most important thing for any genome is percent GC, the GC percent, the number of Gs and Cs. And ideal for any human is about 52%. But these days, 48 is also okay, given the brevity of the challenge that we really face with the number of sequence outliers that we have. Number of false positives coming up. So this is the FRET quality score, nothing but per base sequence quality. Okay, so as I told you, above score 30 is always good. All the values that are coming in gray areas, green areas are always good. The above 20 or 25 is orange, which is mediocre, and pink is worse. Okay, and it says that for every base across the position in the read, you have got this particular score. And this box plot, you need to take the measure of these particular last box, bar pins, as you could see. Okay, until then you have to see. As you could see, some of the regions have really come at the end, you know, to a mediocre region, but it's okay, you need not really worry. Okay, can someone tell me why is that, you know, some of the regions are not so good at the start, at the end? Can someone tell me, please?
So it is a linker adapter sequence.
Wonderful, wonderful. Very good. This is what I really wanted. Absolutely. So if there are linkers, you know, sometimes they're all synthetic bases. The sequencing may not really, you know, read properly. Okay. But sometimes, you know, that can be trimmed. Even if you want to keep it like that, it doesn't matter. Okay. So please don't worry about that. So it could be because of those linkers and adapters. Nevertheless, you should not really worry. And per tile sequence quality across the tile, 150 bases, across those 1101 times, the quality is it deteriorated. If there are any white bars, the quality is very bad. So, which means this is an hybridized bar, right? If you remember that slide, that hybridization, several bases are there. So that hybridization map, it is showing you. Per sequence quality score. So per sequence, what is the score? As I told you, 30 and above is quite good. So most of this is above, you know, 29 or above. The average score is almost so many number of sequences, what we call the mean sequence quality of the score. Okay. And per base sequence content, what is percent A, percent T, percent C, percent G? Okay. Ideally, it should be about 25%. So there's a little above 29 here in case of you know, per A. Okay. That doesn't matter. So this is across the length and breadth of those 150 base bits. And this is a theoretical one, the blue bar and the GC count per read is the accurate one which you have seen. So it's somewhere about 46%, which is okay. You should not really worry, you know, with the GC percent if it is about 46 or 47. If it is less than 45, then you should really worry. In case of metagenomes, in case of bacteria, even it is sometimes 38 or 39%. So please don't worry about that. Okay. And per base and content, sometimes not necessarily every base is read as A, T, G, and C. Sometimes there is noise. Okay. That noise is called as per base and content. Okay. So there is a noise. You see, there is no noise, but there is some noise here. There's a small flip here, as you could say. And sequence length distribution, usually it should be 150 bases because 150 bases are chopped off every length. So ideally it's about 150 bases across the length distribution. So someone asked me if there are any duplications. Yes, if there are duplicated sequences or deduplicated sequences, there are no duplicated sequences more than three bases, as you could see, which means the quality is absolutely super, absolutely great. Okay, but the very first sequences, you know, there are duplicated sequence and no overrepresented sequences. And what is the adapter that was used? It's a pink, it's a solid small RNA adapter, which is seen in pink color. Okay. So this is how your quality is, right? You should check the quality for both. If it's a paired end, you need to check for R1 and as well as R2. Okay. So I'm just curious if anyone is working towards this. Sorry, not this. I'm in the server, right? So if anyone is working, you can also work. You can simply go to that. If you want to exit the directory, you have to type cd dot dot, change directory and exit the current directory. Okay. And then again, type list minus L. You can go to virus. In virus also, you have a file, a FASTQ file. Why is there only one FASTQ file? Okay. Can you tell me why? Why there is only one FASTQ file?
Maybe it's a single-stranded virus. It is single-stranded virus.
Very, no. The sequencing chemistry is single end chemistry, single read chemistry, not the paired end chemistry.
Okay.
In case of paired end, in case of test one and test two, it's read one and read two. Okay. It's oriented from both ends, but in case of virus, they have only gone for single end chemistry. Okay. So I'm exiting. I'm going to fungi. So in Fungi, there is also one file. It's also a single end chemistry. Okay, you can run fast QC for that as well. Okay. And in case of bacteria, I have copied one nucleotide file. If someone is a bacterial biologist, you can also run a quality check for that. Okay, you can also do that. It's an FNA file, not a FQ file, a FASTQ file. Okay, so please don't worry. FNA is fast nucleotide sequence. Okay. So what I really want is to you please log in to Human. Okay. Go there. Please don't alter any other files. If you really want to create a directory, you can create a directory like mkdir, say crash. Okay. I can go to crash. Okay. And run fastqc. The file is present in the previous folder, right? So you can write fastqc in the previous folder like this. Run test1.fq. Okay. Then you can give ampersand if you really want to come to the next prompt. Okay. So likewise, create your own folders, run this particular command. I'll give you 10 minutes to work on this, and then we'll sit until 8:15 or 8:30 today. Okay. And then we'll run some exercises until the next few days as well. So please don't worry. You will be running at least whole exome sequencing and whole transcriptome pipeline in the next, I would say, 12 days. Okay. So you'll become a complete next generation sequencing biologist. So can you quickly run all of you? I really want to see your folders. If you pose any problems, please let me know. Okay? Yes. I hope you're all able to do that. I can see whether or not you're doing or not. Okay. If there is no folder created on your name, I can clearly see. Yeah, Nish has created, Diniti, Anubhav, wonderful. Oh, the folders are being created. Wonderful. Awesome. Good. I'll wait here. So someone has created a folder somewhere in virus. No, no one has done. Okay, good. Fungal, no one has done. Okay, you please do. So all are hopefully human biologists. So please do that. Yeah. Okay. If you have any problems, please feel free to ask. Okay. But all of you, please, all of you, please do that. Huh? So, Anshu, could you log in, please? Yeah.
I've logged in, but I don't know how to go ahead after that.
Yeah. Can you see a small terminal window?
Yeah.
Yeah. You please click that. You will get this.
Which terminal window?
You can share the screen for a while if you want.
Yeah.
I can stop the share screen here. Yes. So if you can see a terminal window next to synchronize. Yes, click that. Yeah, the black one. Yeah. Click that. Yes, okay. Yeah, now run, you need to have a PuTTY actually, you know. I'm sorry, please install PuTTY, then you can directly enter through this because, yeah.
Okay.
Please install PuTTY. Yeah. The WinSCP version is not allowing you. Yeah, if you have PuTTY, that will automatically go, you'll see screen like this, yeah. You can stop the screen, yeah. Good. So all of you have entered. I think that sounds good.
Sir, this is Anubhav.
Yeah.
It is giving me that analysis complete for test1.fq. Then what I have to do?
You need not do anything. You just wait for the result. That's it. You just wait for the result. Yeah.
Okay.
No, but did you run going to your Anubhav website, Anubhav folder?
Yes, I have given that command mkdir Anubhav. Then I have given the command cd Anubhav. Then I have given fastq space dot dot backslash test1.fq.
Then it
gave the result that started analysis of test1.fq, approx 5%.
Yeah, it will take time.
And then it gave the command that analysis complete for test1.fq. Analysis complete for test1.fq.
Then did you get any file? I don't see your file is created. I don't know why.
I can't follow. Actually, I am using that WinCP, that one that Ansu was showing. That thing I am using actually.
Yeah. Okay. Then you have to go. You are WinCP user, right?
Yes.
Are you using PuTTY as well?
I have installed PuTTY. So,
can you please share the screen? Yeah.
Okay.
Your results will be somewhere in your folder over there. Yeah. I don't know why in Anubhav you didn't get the file here. I cannot see any file here. Yeah, press enter. No, you need to use PuTTY for that. Although it will run. Yeah, enter. I don't know why it has not created this thing. I think now it is done. It is still doing it. Because in Anubhav, when you do that, there's no file that is created here. I don't know why. Are you getting an error? When you run it, you are not getting an error, right?
No error. Just as you can see, it is running that file, the started analysis of, and it is going on.
Yeah, I don't know why this file is not created here, but I'll probably run this for you.
If you can see the command is being
given. Please install PuTTY as well. Yeah.
So can I share my screen and help me?
Yeah, please. Yeah, I think it will run. I think it will run. I'm also doing it. You log in through PuTTY, Anubhav. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, and please close it. Yeah. Maybe you can start sharing the screen, Anshu. Yeah.
So I have installed PuTTY, so again I have to log out and again log in again?
Yes, please log out and log in through PuTTY this time. Yeah. So KK has created two folders. What about others? Ignacio, Chimasha, Esther.
Sir, how can I stop? Share. Okay. I couldn't find that stop sharing file. I was asking. Okay.
Right. Yeah. How about others? Himani Malhotra, Diniti, Dave Fernando, Rakhi Vadva, Ignacio, others, Abu, are you all able to do that? Anamika? Yeah. So you should really get those particular files. How about others?
I'm sharing my screen. Can you help me? What I got.
Yeah, please. Yeah. So now,
aren't you?
Go to CD. CD workshop. CD.
Okay.
Yeah. CD space workshop. Yeah.
It's not focusing, right?
Yeah. Enter. Yeah. Now go to LS minus L, LS space minus L. Yes. So you have got those things. Now you can go to humans, CD space. Human, H is capital. You can simply type tab, then automatically it will come. Yeah. Again, LS minus L. Okay. So you have got that particular thing. So you can create a folder with your name, mkdir, make directory, space, Anshu.
Is this correct?
Mkdir, dir.
It's one word,
right? And you can keep anything. Yeah. Now go to that directory cd Anshu. Cd space Anshu. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
So 1 minute. Yeah, and now you run the command fastqc. Space dot dot forward slash. Yeah, test one dot fq. And please don't press enter. 1 minute. I'm just checking, you know, why. I think it's running. 1 minute. Yeah, the test one, since I've created, you're not able to run it. So I'm just changing the permission. So don't worry about that. Yeah. So could you all run it? Yeah.
So just a minute, Prash. Probably they are not getting files because the output is putting into the same folder where the source file is there. So they need to extend that command with fastqc space dot dot slash test q.
The file is dot different. That's one of the reasons why I asked them to. Yeah. No.
Dot fq.
No. That's one of the reasons why I asked them to create their own folder so that they'll get the outputs.
No, even then it will not create actually. Space minus O space dot. enter. Now it will create the output in the same folder where she is, so which is in the Anshu.
Yeah.
What next?
Okay. Now you can check the files with ls prompt.
Ls?
Yeah. So for WinSCP or PuTTY, it's the same thing, but yeah, ls minus l. Yeah, now you go to WinSCP and you can copy that file.
So wait,
you can drag and drop. No, yours is run. test1_fastqc.html is run. Okay. That's output. Yeah, now please go to WinSCP. Now you please go to WinSCP. Yeah. Log in over there as well.
Huh. Workshop, no,
and drag and drop that file, yeah.
Where is the file?
Where I have to drag those file from?
Somebody can share the complete screen, we can tell. Right now, Anshu, you're not sharing the complete screen. You shared only one window.
Yeah, if you can share the screen. Go to humans. Go to human, yeah. And there you have your own folder, yeah. And drag that into somewhere here, yeah.
Drag that
Drag it, yeah.
To the cell.
Yes. Yes. Yes, okay. And now open that file directly.
The zip file?
Yeah, there's no need of zip file. Yeah, you can directly open HTML file. Yeah. Double click it. Yeah.
Can you see this? No, you can't.
No, I think there's some error here. I think right click, open with Google Chrome or browser. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, Anubha, you were saying something. Yeah. You can share the screen, Anubha. We'll tell you.
Okay. I have done it, I think. I am sharing the screen.
Yeah, you have to give minus O, you know, since that's a good point, you know, minus O space. Okay, or you can give minus O dot. Space dot. Oh, you already copied it, is it?
Yes, I have copied it. Actually, I was following up.
You already copied it, is it?
Yes. I have copied it and then I have tried to open it with Google Chrome, that HTML file, and then I have got this result. Actually, I was catching up with Anshu only because the problem which Anshu was facing, I was facing that problem too. So I was following whatever you were directing Anshu only.
I got the report here. Now this is what you wrote.
Yeah, I think this is done. So all of you have done, hopefully, all the things. Yeah. So the first QC is done. So can at least 10 people would say if it is done?
I am Anubhav. I think in my case it is done, right? What I have displayed to you.
Yeah, you're done. Yeah, you, okay. You and Anshu have done. Thank you. Yeah. How about okay. Others? Yeah.
Okay. Thank you so much, sir.
I have done it.
Yeah. In Mac terminal, you can go through that folder again. Just like Windows, you can open up directly. Yeah. So if you're done with this, I think the major chunk is done. I'll tell you the next few commands quickly, please. Yes, sir. Quickly, please. Yeah.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, please, Lipsa.
This is Lipsa. Actually, sir, I'm a window user. So I'm using PuTTY basically. So after like, I got the result. I also followed up with Miss Ansu. Then I got up the result.
Prash, we are not able to hear you.
Sir, I'm sorry. I had a disconnection.
Okay.
Yeah, hello. Yeah, I just had a brief disconnection.
Yeah, now audible.
Yeah, I just had a brief disconnection. I'm really sorry for this. So you can see the screen here. So you ran something called FastQC, which is the very first step. I think you have created all your folders and all those kind of things. Okay. So now the most important thing is if you have your test1.fq like this and test2.fq like this, you need to, you know, map it to your reference genome. Okay. So reference genome in this case, since assuming that these are all the human files. Okay. So you need to ensure that you need to map it to your reference. So in order to map it to your reference, there are different tools. One is Bounty 2, okay, which is a tool, you know, which tries to tell you whether or not this particular sequence is in close approximation with your index for your genome. And then you need to give your two reads, -1 and -2, in case of your paired end. If it is unpaired, you need to give -u. Okay. So this is the command, you know, that you need to give it. The final file is -s, the SAM file, okay? The sequence alignment mapping, okay? So what we do is, if you give Bounty2-build, you can build your own reference, okay? So simply, say for example, if you have a G38, which is a human genome 38 for human reference, you can build your own reference like Bounty2-build and then a G38. So simply, you simply give your reference index, okay, and your base, which means if it is Bounty2, that file name and what would be the file name being called, that you need to give your as a prefix, okay. So Bounty2, the file name is HG38, you need to give HG38, you know, as a prefix, okay. So likewise, okay, we have given, no, this is our HG38 index. Okay, we have got 1000 genome VCF file as well, which is 6.9 GB. We have got all SNPs across the human genome. Okay, we have got the exact database, several things. So we have got the HG38, which is 3.1 GB, so which is about 3.2 billion base pairs. Okay, that's the size of it. Okay. And this,
sir, can you please once again repeat what is that actually HG38?
So HG38 is a name for your genome reference for humans. Okay, so HG38 is human genome build 38. That is a reference name. Okay, so it's HG19 or HG38. Earlier it was called, the earliest version is HG37 actually. Okay. And the earlier version was HG34. And now the latest version that is coming up is HG39, which is coming, you know, sometime in December. Okay. So that is a new nomenclature that is given for the human reference. HG is human genome 38. Okay. So that is a number given to that particular reference. Okay.
So from what I understand, HG number it comes from compiling a data from lots of people.
Compiling from, sorry?
Lots of individuals. Like the first genome was not many people. But now what we're doing is compiling a lot of people's data.
No, it's not that. You know, they take an assemblies, you know, several assemblies, but they come up with a consensus assembly. The very first assembly was HE16 actually. Okay. And then they upgraded it, and only not all the published assemblies are, not all assemblies are published. Only the one that is well curated, you know, that is published.
So is this does this include people from all kinds of regions, or only is it European basically?
Yes, all over the world. It's all over the world. As I told you, it's all over the world.
Thank you.
So HE38, so please don't go by numbers, okay? 38 is only a reference number, okay? Like your telephone number. So HE38.fa is your file name. So if you really want to see how that particular file looks like, again, I can type HE38, okay, cat. It is this in this path, okay? Okay, so I'm just giving the cat is concatenate. So I can press it. So as you could see, it is A's, T's, C's, and G's. All the small letters are all the introns, and all the cap.
Rash, we lost your voice again.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I had a brief disconnection again. I apologize for this.
Yep.
So usually the capital letters are all the exons, and the small letters are all the introns here, as you could see. Yeah. Is my voice audible now? Yeah, I'm sorry for this. Yeah.
Yes, Prashant.
Yeah. So thank you. So this is how it is. And then if I gave cat is view or concatenate, okay. But if you really want to see the only the header files, okay, head, then as you could see the very first chromosome, there is a lot of noise. N is noise, which means it has not read either A, T, or G, or C. Okay. So this is what we call it as noise, N. Okay. So please don't worry about this. So is my screen visible? Yeah.
Yes, sir. So for what reasons this noise can appear?
It's only simply because of a machine artifact or an error where after the library preparation, maybe the machine couldn't detect what is that A or T or G or C. Okay. So okay. N is a noise.
Okay.
Not mapped, you know, something like that. It's simply an error, you know, while doing the sequencing. Okay. So likewise, you can also check the tail as well. Tail is the last few lines of the file. Okay. If you see the chromosome Y, that thing you'll get. All the small letters are again in introns, and capital letters are on exons.
So is noise always in the beginning and the end, the head and the tail?
Not necessary. That's a good question, but not necessary. It all depends on the sequencing instrument. It all depends on on how good your library is prepared, how good the technician is, okay, and how robust is the instrumentation with respect to the sensitivity. Okay, yeah. So when you give head minus say 50, it will give you the first 50 lines. Okay, you see even the first 50 lines for chromosome 1 has got a lot of noise. If you're curious, you can give minus 500. Okay. So yes, you see, maybe it is there. So the top 500 lines is good. So somewhere here, you know, it is starting. So this is your human genome 38 chromosome first that is starting with. Okay. So this is your file. Okay. So now this is there. Now you need to run a simplest body. You need to map it. So body 2. Okay. When you give body 2, the command is like this, okay? Bauti 2 minus x is your Bauti index. Minus 1 is your first read, minus 2 is your second read, and minus s is your sample, okay? So I'm running it. So let me run through my folder. Okay. I don't know why it's.
Please explain what Bounty is doing.
So Bounty maps. Yeah, Bounty maps your sequence to your reference genome. Okay. So what it does is, you know, since you have a reference genome, you really want to map your sequence. Okay, your sequence that you have obtained from your service provider or from your machine, and check whether or not it is aligning properly with your human genome or not, or your organism genome or not.
Thank you.
Okay. Okay. Yeah. So now you can simply give Bounty 2, okay, minus X, okay. That is the command that you need to give. As you could see, this is the command. And then, sorry, it's not capital, it's small x, minus x, okay? That Bounty reference you need to give, and the path is this, okay? D is capital, HG38 and HG38, okay? That is the index that you need to give. Index is this, okay? Which means the index would be HG38.FA.BT1, BT2, BT3 and all. So what Bounty build does is, sorry, Ashok, your voice is not clear. Yeah. Ashok, yeah. No, I'm sorry. Yeah. So, so you need to give that. So whenever you give Bounty to build, okay. Earlier, you know, I didn't show you how to build a Bounty brevity. So what happens is, if this is your genome, it will split into six parts. So first part, second part, third part, and fourth part, and it will give a reference. And reverse also, it will give one and two. So total is six. So reverse, it will split into two parts, taking the reference. And the first is the four parts. So that four parts, which I think I have shown you, I'm just showing you again. So if you give a show list at this particular path, as you could see here, HG38.1.BT2, HG38.2.BT2, 3.BT2, and 4.BT2. Likewise, reverse 2 and reverse 1. Okay. So if you sum up this, this will be 3.2 GB data, all the six files. Okay. So that is how your Bounty 2 is built. So this is what I'm just trying to give now. So simply give Bounty 2 minus X. That path for already existing Bounty, okay? HG38, and minus one is your test one file, okay? And minus two is your test two file, and minus S is your SAM file. What is your file? So your, since your sample name is test, simply give test.sam, okay? That is how, you know, you need to give. And then since you are running Linux, always know, since some jobs might take a lot of time, simply give ampersand so that you can come to your command prompt carefully. And the job ID is created. Okay. Sorry, I gave a wrong spelling, Bounty, B-O-W-T-I. Okay, sorry. Huh? And a job ID is created, then it is giving some this thing. So don't worry if it is showing up something. So SAM is created now. Okay. OMNGS. Sorry, I forgot the file name. Yeah. Okay. And then, yeah. So test.sam is created, as you could see. Okay. So LRTH. So test.sam, usually it starts with in a very slow pace. Okay. So I'm just clear the screen so that I can come to the top. So this is the command that I've given, Bounty 2 minus X, home NGS data, HG38. HG38 is the index file, okay? Minus one test1.fq, minus two test2.fq, minus S is capital, and the file name, the SAM file. SAM is sequence alignment mapping file, okay? And then, Sorry for this. So I was a bit disappointed, you know, disconnected. So so test.sam is created. You see the SAM file is now 872K. Okay. Now 1.2 MB. It is increasing slowly. Okay. It's 1.5 MB. So it is still increasing. So let it run. The sequence alignment mapping file is there. Now I'll show you what is sequence alignment mapping file. Okay. All of this, please, you know, try doing this. Okay.
Sir, can you please show us the bothy command that command which
yeah,
you
this
give?
One,
yeah.
Yeah, this one. So here you can, if you want to go to your individual folders, you have to go to your individual folders. But again, as I told you, if you are going to that folder, you need to give like this. Okay, like this. So you are giving the file path to your previous folder. Okay, if you are say going to that particular folder, so you can do this. Okay, and don't worry about minus O option now, since minus this is already given. Okay, so it will run. So this is what you need to do after you run your go to your individual folder and run it. Okay, so please try doing this. We'll just wait. I think good number of folders have been created. I'm really glad. I think others have not created. How about others, please?
After I have gone into my folder, then I will be giving this command only, which you are showing here, right?
Right, yeah.
And there will be nothing like that in that previous one that there was minus.
No. Okay. You have to give this. Yeah. How about others, please? Yeah. It will be nice, you know, if others, you know, say yes or no, please. I sincerely appreciate. Otherwise, please quit this meeting, please. If you have any questions, I will be happy to answer. Yeah. SAM file, okay, assuming that you are running it, so I can see the header of the SAM file. So I'm giving head minus 20 test.sam. okay, so I'll see the top few lines of the SAM file. Okay, so this is how it looks. Can you see the screen, all of you? Yeah, I can see here. Okay, so this is what you get. So SAM is a sequence alignment mapping file. It's usually the 3 times the size of your FASTQ file usually. Okay, that's reason why you don't run the SAM files in a directory. Okay, so it says header, version, SVO is sorted or not. It's unsorted, so which means it's not sorted chromosome wise. As you could see, first is serial number, you are getting chromosome 1, line number is this, it has read this, but it has jumped to sequence chromosome 10 as per the sequence number. Okay, so it's sequence number. It is going very random. It is not coming, you know, chromosome 1 or chromosome 2 like this. Okay, so but this can be sorted. Okay, but this sorting option can be done once you convert this SAM to BAM. Okay, BAM is binary alignment mapping. Okay, that, you know, we can run using something called SAM tools. But if you run until SAM step, I'll be happy today, and then we can move forward. Yeah.
Sir, when I am trying to run this boat, it is showing that there are some connection issues and I have got disconnected. So I will be again wanting that actually that command, bow tie command once again, because I have lost it.
No, maybe you lost the connection. You need to log in again, Anuba.
I think the issue is because the task files doesn't have an execution permission. So it happened to me also in WCP has a WinSCP has a problem with execution permissions in FASTQ files.
No, I don't think. Let me see permissions. Let me see. Yeah. CD human.
Server fits the use when we try to.
Execute. Yeah, yeah. Yes. No, I can set it 1 minute. Yeah.
So if you are disconnected, you have to start all over again.
Yeah, sorry. Yeah.
In case you're disconnected, you have to start all over again.
Yeah, you can start all over again, but your files will be saved. So please don't worry about that. Okay.
If so I type the command about disconnected.
Yeah. Yeah. Since you are given an ampersand, your file, your job will be interrupted actually. Okay. But you know, if you want that interruption also to be accepted, then you need to give something called NoHub. NoHub is no hangout. Okay. So that is a different thing. If your computer fails or if your computer shuts down, or maybe you want to come and check your job at a later point of time, or you can use screen command as well. Okay. But since these are all the remote servers, I really wouldn't suggest that. Okay. Logging in, you know, to the remote server, especially to our BASS servers, you know, profusely so and so time, I really don't want to tell you those commands. Okay. Yeah.
So can I present my
commands?
Sir, can I present my share my screen and so that you can guide me?
Please. Yeah. How about Ignacio, please? Yeah. So Nish, I think you should be able to run now. I set to all free, all open. So the files are all open. So you'll be able to run now. Yeah.
So you can see I am giving this boutique command.
I cannot see your screen. 1 minute. Maybe I need to stop. I don't know. Kiran, do I need to stop the screen?
You don't have to actually, there will be multiple screens possible. So you should just figure it out here in your gallery of screens. So you need to change your view, then it should be possible.
Yeah, I got it. Yeah, thank you. Yeah. Okay. So Anuba, I suggest you install Putty, please. Anuba, I suggest you install Putty, please. Yeah.
Okay, the Putty
this is
installed.
Not a good way.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, please log in through Putty. Yeah. Yeah. How about others? Ignacio, Abu, KK, are you all able to do that? Yeah. Rocky? No, I don't think now you have permission.
So, can I share my screen for a minute?
Nish, can you do that?
Yeah, I think how it's working.
Okay. Please.
Sir, this is my screen.
Are you all able to log in?
Yes, sir. I have logged in through Putty. So, will I share my screen or Angsu share my share her screen?
I've shared my screen. Do you want me to stop?
No. You continue. I so that I can follow up from you only. You have shared that.
Sir, I typed in this command, and can you see it, sir?
Yeah.
And
this is
what I got.
No, you please come down. You please come down.
1 second.
Please come down to the new prompt. Please come down to the new prompt. Please come down. Yeah.
Can you see it, sir?
Please type PWD. Enter. So you are in test. So you should be in workshop human. So you go to CD workshop, CD space, workshop, enter. Again, CD space human.
Okay, I've come out of it. That's why. Yeah.
Now CD Anshu. No, N and small. Now go, you can use the up arrow command and go to your previous command. Up, use the up arrow from there. Go up. Yeah. Now go to minus one position.
Yeah.
Minus X.
So,
space.
I don't know how to remove the space.
Between minus X and. No, okay. You have to take a cursor. You have to take your prompt. Left. Yes.
And go to?
Minus X space.
Before or after? I have to remove the space?
No. Minus X is just normal. No space. And then after that space, and then go to minus one. Yes. And type dot forward slash. Space dot forward slash. You have to give space. Yes. How about other space and also for test two as well? Yeah, minus two, test two. And then you can run the command. Give ampersand so that you can get back to your next.
So there's something wrong here, this one? Just see one.
No, you need space between forward slash and test one, please.
This has to be removed, okay.
That space should be removed, not forward slash. No space, yeah.
Is it okay now? Yeah.
Yes. And likewise for test two as well, dot. Because you're citing that file that is present in your previous directory.
So this is after this dot?
No. Like the way that you are given for minus one, dot.
Huh. Okay, yeah, I got it. Okay. Slash.
What yes. Slash? No space.
Okay. It's just...
And then at the end, type ampersand and run the command. Yeah. Space and. So what you're trying to do with this command is you're aligning your reads to your reference called HG38. Okay. How does it align? I'll show you once I check the, you know.
So this 28437, that number is the size of it?
No, that's a job ID. That's a job ID. So please don't worry.
Yeah.
So what about others? Yeah. Now I'm a bit disappointed why I'm not really hearing from others, please. I think there are 33 participants. There are 33 participants. I only get to hear only from two or three people.
Sir, this is Anubhav. I have also created one job.
Anubhav, 1 minute, please. Anubhav, 1 minute, please. Okay. Just please hold on. Yeah. How about others, please? Aparna, would you please tell your student if he's okay? So, Nish, you are able to run the pipeline, you know, with your group members, right? Yeah.
Yeah,
Ashok.
Yeah,
Ashok. I hope your students are doing it. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm struggling. Students are doing good. Because I have to skip 1 hour.
it's working good.
Thank you.
Yeah, no, I don't. Karishma, Kamini, Rakhi Vadva. Yeah, please. Are you able to do that? Yeah. Yeah, KK, are you able to do that from Bangladesh? Yeah, everything good?
Good. I'm trying to execute the bowtie command again. Something similar.
Okay, good. So if you pose any problems, please let me know. Okay, yeah, thank you. Yeah. So this is your so-called, the SAM file. Okay, this is how your SAM file looks like with all those kind of things. But if you see here, The size of your sample is it's 741. It's my time is also 741 here. It's 38 MB. It's still running. Okay. So the size is about 98 MB, and it will take up to 98 times at least 3. Okay. So it will be about 300 MB approximately once it finishes. Okay.
Stop sharing my screen, please.
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah.
So and then you can also set the speed as well. Ours is a 64 processors. You can use up to 16 threads or 24 threads, but I don't really want to use that multi processing 3D imaging here. Okay, it's only for your basic thing, assuming that you have only one code processor working on your computer. Okay, so this is how you can run your basic command. So once you have a SAM file, as I told you, the SAM file is quite big. Okay, so you need to convert that SAM to a BAM file. BAM is a binary alignment mapping. Okay, so for that there's something called SAM tools. Okay, SAM tools is a command that you would do that. So I don't know why it is not showing 1 minute. I'm just installing it. So Bauti does this, as I told you, there is a HiSat 2 as well. So you know the difference between SAM tools and HiSat 2, right? Yeah.
No, sir, please explain.
Yeah. So as I told you, if you have spliced alignments, if you have multiple alignments that are mapping from your sequence reads to your reference, okay, then you can use HiSat 2. Okay, so multiple copies of those spliced alignments can be graciously checked using HiSat 2. But Bauti 2 is a normal thing. It might skip some of the spliced alignments. Okay, spliced alignments is those small truncations of those particular reads that are read from the machine actually. Okay, yeah. So I'll also show you HiSat 2, but I really want to run the whole genome or whole exome sequence pipeline, before this week, so that next week we can run whole transcriptome, and then you can play around with multiple tools. Okay, once you are getting used to this. In fact, our server is down over the last 2 days. There was a miswiring, so that's the reason why our server is damn slow actually. Okay. So I'm sorry, I don't know what happened with SAM tools. So I'm just reinstalling it. It's just taking 1 minute here. Yeah, actually, yeah. So it's still running 1 minute, yeah. So in the meantime, if you have any questions, please feel free to ask.
I'm able to run fast queue now. I may be 1 hour late, but
yeah, wonderful.
I'm very happy.
Ignacio?
Sir, after creating the job ID, Sir, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Yeah. After creating that job ID, can I share my screen? I have also tried to install that SAM tools, but it is showing some error.
No. Don't install SAM tools. Don't install SAM tools. SAM tools I'm installing. You know, it will be installed all over the bin. Okay. So please don't do that. Once you run your Bounty 2, you will get your SAM file in your folder. Okay. So please see that SAM folder by typing head. Okay.
What command I will have to use to find out that whether that SAM file is created or not?
You can type ls minus l list. I don't know why this is taking this much time, 1 minute. Yes, now SAM tools is installed. Okay. So now what you could do is you have got a SAM file. Okay. Like this. The SAM file is 59 MB. It's still running 747. Okay. So now you can run SAM tools with the simplest command. So you can convert your SAM to BAM actually. Okay, but what happens is the most important stuff with such reference mapping is you need to import the reference based mapping as well whenever you use SAM tools. Okay, so you're assuming that Bounty 2 has run. Okay, but the Bounty 2 mapping may not really be accurate, and keeping that thing as a view, you are using, you know, something called SAM tools. Okay. In this case, you could have simply run SAM tools view. Okay. What is the SAM file? Test.sam. And like this. Okay. You can do this if you want. But it says, you know, it's end of the file, marker is absent, it's truncated, which means the file is still running. Okay. So don't worry. Once it is done, you can run this particular command. Okay. Once you run it. Okay. So don't worry about that. So what you could do is, so you can run SAM tools, a command called import. Okay. Import is a wonderful, command for SAM tools. Okay. So once you give SAM tools import, you need to give your reference. So your reference is, okay, HG38. Here you need to give full name, the file name, hg38.fa. And what is the file name? Test.sam. And the output should be test.bam. Okay. And simply type ampersand or minus o test.bam also you can give. Okay. So the reason why you are using SAM tools import option is you are importing your reference hg38.fa to be mapped with your sequence alignment mapping, whether or not you're rechecking it. Earlier with Bounty 2, you have used this until here, okay? Until HG38. But you are using Bounty 2 with this, assuming that your alignment would be mapped across the length and breadth, okay? But here, when you're using SAM tools import, you're converting your SAM to BAM, okay? But you're giving your reference intact. So it will double check and see if every sequence or if every line number is read properly or not. Okay, so SAM tools import this. And then it is checking all those kinds. So test.bam is still being created, I think. Okay. Test.sam is there, but test.bam is still being created. Okay. So this is how, you know, your SAM to BAM conversion takes place. It will take some time, so let it run. It's since our file is a very small file. I gave a truncated file. So what I do is, for you to check, you can log into the server at any given point of time in the night during these 10 days. Okay, so don't worry. Okay, so what you will do is, you will I'll copy a real file, okay, which is of some size, okay, since these files are the truncated files. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll copy here in humans. Okay, so these files will be copied in about 20-25 minutes. These are pretty huge files. Okay, you can use z14_1.fq and z14_2.fq to run your own files. Okay, so please go through your folder, run fastqc if you want again, run Bounty 2 and run sandtools import. Okay, until these three steps, this is your homework for tomorrow. Okay, please.
Sir, can you please provide us with that sequence? The command lines which we have to write.
Sure. What I'm just trying to do is, I'm just trying to copy paste that path. Okay, we have our own scripts actually. Okay, so I'll try to give you the this thing. Don't worry. Okay. So what I'm doing is, I'm copying So what I've done right now is, I've copied a file called xpipe_12.sh. So if you click cat xpipe, okay. Sorry, I need to go there. I'm sorry. Or I can give like this cat. So this, in fact, basically these are all the commands that you'll be running. So you ran this fastqc, bounty2 you ran, okay. SAM tools, you'll be running it like this, okay, until this command you'll run. Okay, this is your homework. So all the commands are there. The other commands also you'll be able to run for ascertaining your variance. Okay, so we need to finish these exercises sometime by Thursday at least, or Friday at least, so that you can redo these exercises until Saturday and Sunday, so that you'll have a good time to finish this exercise. So this is for calling the variance basically. So assuming that your file is a whole exome sequence or a whole genome sequence. Okay. So basically you're running with your file and getting your VCF file, which is a variant calling format, which means you get all the list of variants for that particular sample. Okay. And again, downstream annotation is another big headache that you'll be running. Okay. Is this clear? Any questions? Yeah.
Sir, all this command will be run in our folder. No. So there will be, I think, some changes in that command, right?
Yeah. As I told you, if you need to cite that previous file, you need to give ... Okay. For the previous file, like what you have given. Okay. There are no, it is only a kind of a syntax that I'm just trying to give you. Okay. So, say for example, here, if you want to give z12_1.fq, you need to give ... You need, because that file is present in your previous folder. Okay. Like the way you know that you have done. Okay.
Okay.
So please do this. And I think I should stop here. If you have any questions, I'll be happy to answer. But assuming that there are very few users, I'm a bit surprised from why not many have created folders. Okay. I'm just obligated to be a bit strict with this.
So these all are absent, or they skip in between the session? I lot of blank spaces are there.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. Since these people have not done the exercises, have just typed as actually.
Okay.
So for many of you, I've given present. Yeah, those who have done the exercises, I think I've marked as present. Okay, so. Any questions, please?
Sir, I missed one thing. We did a first QC for the test one file, but did we done the first QC also for test two? I ran it.
Maybe you can also run it. Yeah, if you want, you know. Usually two should be done. Yeah. So this is what you please do this.
I tried to do this with the same command, but at the end of after 90 completing 95%, it shows it failed to use this number like this. Failed to execute the reference type command.
Can you please share the screen? Yeah, or maybe you can share the screenshots in the WhatsApp group. Okay, please use that WhatsApp group. Okay.
Okay.
You know, I'll be happy to answer. You know, if you just put the screenshots and just use the WhatsApp group effectively for brainstorming. Okay. So friends, I think that's it for today. So I think it's 8 o'clock. So I'll be happy to answer any questions if you have, but we'll continue every day from 7:30 to 8 or 7:45 to 8:15 every day. Okay. So I appreciate, you delivering the exercises. Okay. I think, many of you have requested for waivers. We have provided the waivers, but this is not fair if you're not doing the exercises. Okay, these courses are usually taught for about 10,000 rupees. We at BioPlus, we have jotted down to only 2,000 rupees. Okay, so please don't take us for granted. Sorry to be very harsh on this. Okay, yeah. If you're not doing exercises, please quit. That's as simple as this. Okay, there's nothing that we could request to be done than this. Please. Yeah. So thank you so much. Let's thank Kiran as well, for his wonderful time in recording the talk. So thank you so much, Kiran. Yeah.
Yep. Thanks. Thanks, Prashant. Thanks for your wonderful presentation.
Thank you.
I'm stopping.
So see you tomorrow. We have wonderful.